अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट पंक्चुएशन मार्क एंड दैट इज सेमी कॉलन. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम पीपल आर रिलक्टेंट टू यूज दिस पंक्चुएशन मार्क ड्यू टू लैक ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट द यूजेज ऑफ सेमी कॉलन. हाउएवर, आई एम श्योर आफ्टर लिसनिंग टुडेज लेक्चर यू विल लव टू यूज सेमी कॉलन इन योर राइटिंग. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द डूज एंड डोंट्स ऑफ सेमी कॉलन. Author Kurt Vonnegut once wrote, "Don't use semicolons. All they do is show you have been to college." It means that if you use semicolon in your writing, they give an impression of expert writer. They show that you have good level of knowledge related to writing skills. Sometimes we think of it as the super comma because it tells the reader to make more of a stop when reading. The semicolon has three main uses that will help you as you learn to write powerful and exciting essays, and we'll discuss all these three major uses of semicolon in detail today. Okay, semicolons actually show relationship between two independent clauses or between one independent clause and list of items. It is a relationship, a clear relationship between two independent clauses, and it's a two-sided process. Both the clauses have close relationship, have close connection with each other in term of idea and content as well. So let's see some more details. First use shows connection between sentences. And by connecting sentences, semicolon adds more style, diversity, and depth in the sentences. Moreover, once you connect two sentences together through semicolon, there are high chances that you will be able to persuade the reader in a better way. Okay, now we'll see the first use through examples. Here you can see in front of you, there are two sentences. And they are separated through periods. So what is the purpose of period? That it separates the sentences. And the first sentence is, it is raining outside, you cannot go for morning walk. So you can see that both these sentences are independent clauses. They are complete sentences and they are giving the complete sense. One more important thing to observe here is that why of you is capital. It means that whenever you start any sentence after period, you always capitalize the first letter. Fine. But what we do with the help of semicolon, we can join these two sentences together. Here you can see it is raining outside, semicolon, you cannot go for morning walk. So now both the sentences are connected through semicolon. And one more thing, that after semicolon, we are not capitalizing the first letter. You can see here that Y is small. As long as it is not the proper noun, you will not capitalize it. Fine. So now you can see that these two independent clauses are joined together and they are making a compound sentence. Another example is, he loves to drive his car with the top down, semicolon, it makes him feel free and alive. Again, you can see that two independent clauses, two sentences are joined together through semicolon, and I of it is small, right? You need to remember it, because most of the time I observe that people just capitalize this letter the way they do it after period, which is wrong. I am feeling sick, semicolon, I cannot go to school. So this is another example of two sentences connected together through semicolon. And you can see that I is capital. And you are well aware that whenever I is written individually, it is always capitalized. So you can see that now, after adding semicolon, the sentences, the ideas are better connected, and their effect upon each other is strong, right? So this is how, if we want to make our argument more convincing, we can go for semicolon to connect the ideas. Okay, let's move towards the second use. A semicolon can also join forces with a transition, usually a conjunctive adverb, to link two sentences that go together. When used appropriately, a semicolon with a conjunctive adverb can be a very powerful tool. Elegantly using semicolons with conjunctive adverb is an easy way to gain credibility in the eyes of your reader. It means that if you want to make yourself credible as a writer in the eyes of reader, you need to use a semicolon along with conjunctive adverb. Let's see some of the examples. Okay, we can use a semicolon to join two independent clauses when the second clause begins with either a conjunctive adverb or transition. Here I have brought some of the examples for you of conjunctive adverb, like however, therefore, moreover, furthermore, thus, meanwhile, nonetheless, otherwise, and some transitional phrases like in fact, for example, that is, for instance, in addition, in other words, on the other hand, and so on and so forth. So let's see how can we use conjunctive adverb with semicolon. Here you can see that these two sentences are joined together through conjunctive adverb. And actually what is happening, both these sentences are complete independent clauses. The dog was right on her heels. This is independent clause. And she made it in the house before it caught her. This one is also independent clause. And we have joined them through conjunctive adverb, however. And you can also see semicolon. It means that after the first sentence, we add semicolon, conjunctive adverb, and remember, we'll always separate it through comma with the next sentence or next independent clause. I hope it's clear. Okay, let's move. Okay, the next example is again in front of you. Terrorism in the United States has become a recent concern, semicolon, in fact, comma, the concern for America's safety has led to an awareness of global terrorism. So again, here you can see we have two independent clauses, we have two complete sentences, and they are joined together through transitional phrase and then semicolon. So again, the same rule, we separated the two sentences through semicolon and comma. Next example, my car payments are high, semicolon. On the other hand, comma, I really enjoy driving such a nice vehicle. So again, you can see these are the independent clauses and this is transitional phrase and semicolon is serving as a conjunction here, right? And it is joining the clauses together, right? Third use is that semicolon helps us to avoid confusion. We also use a semicolon when we have a list that might be confusing, such as one where individual list items already have commas in them. So let's see one example. Here you can see the scholarship recipients are Muhammad Ali from Lahore, Pakistan, Maria Gulf from Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, and Talha Khan from London, the United Kingdom. And you can see that there are a lot of commas here, which can be really confusing for the reader. So we need to make the job of our reader easy. And how would we do so? We'll just replace some of the commas with semicolon, where we need to separate the items from each other. Like we need to separate Muhammad Ali from Lahore, Pakistan, from Maria Gul from Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, in order to avoid the confusion. And this is what we have done here, right? So after adding semicolon, there is no more confusion. Now the items, the ideas would not mixed up with each other. And you can see that we are adding semicolon before conjunction and, right? This is also necessary because again, it is showing that we are still separating the list, right? So this is how we do it. The next example, the meeting will be chaired by Mr. Aliyaman, who will lead the finance department, Ms. Maria Hashmi, keynote speaker and head of HR department, and Mr. Muhammad Ayub, the vice president of our company. Again, you can see there are many commas here and they can be quite confusing for your reader. So what we'll do, again, we will separate the items through semicolon. Right, we separated Mr. Muhammad Ali, who will lead the finance department, semicolon, Ms. Maria Hashmi. Now this is another component, we'll separate it through semicolon again. So you can see that after adding semicolon, the reader will not be confused. the list would not be mixed up, right? Where not to use semicolon? If it is important to understand where should we use semicolon, we also need to understand that where should we not use semicolon. For example, we cannot use semicolon to connect incomplete sentences. Like here in this example, you can see, I like to buy the dresses, comma, even though they are quite expensive. So we cannot add semicolon here. The reason is that first one is complete sentence. I like to buy the dresses. This is complete sentence. This is independent clause. But this one, even though they are quite expensive, this is dependent clause. That's why we cannot join two incomplete sentences or one independent and one dependent clause through semicolon. That would be a run-on sentence and that would be a mistake. Similarly, between complete sentences that include coordinating conjunction, if there is already coordinating conjunction for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so, the famous fanboys, even then we will not add the semicolon, because semicolon itself is serving the function of coordinating conjunction. So we'll either use semicolon or we'll go for coordinating conjunction, right? We cannot use both of them together. To introduce a list, right? We cannot introduce a list through semicolon. Rather, we should move towards using colon. For example, please bring the essentials, colon. You can see double dots, your identity card, luggage, and air ticket. But one more important thing to remember here is, don't use semicolon too often. It's a precious punctuation mark, and using it frequently can lose its worth. So, for example, if you are writing an essay of 5 paragraphs, it means that in each paragraph you are supposed to use semicolon once, not more than that. Fine. Things to keep in mind: just check whether you can put a period between two sentences. If you can put a period, it means that you can put a semicolon as well by replacing period. When you join two sentences with a semicolon, make sure they are closely related. There should be relationship, there should be a link between those two sentences in term of idea. You should limit how much you use them. Too much of a good thing is not good. So we are not supposed to take semicolon for granted. We'll just use it rarely in our writing, as I already explained it to you. You only capitalize a word following a semicolon if it is a proper noun. Otherwise, you will not capitalize the letter. Lesson summary. So when you are using the semicolon, it is important to remember that you have 3 possible uses available. Use it when you are joining 2 complete sentences together to make 1 sentence. Actually, you go for compound sentence when you use semicolon to join 2 complete sentences. Use a semicolon when you have 2 sentences that join forces with the transition, and use a semicolon when you have a list that might be confusing. Things to remember again, give it a try. When you use it correctly, it adds complexity to your sentences. So take a chance and give it a try. So here I have brought an exercise for you to check your understanding, and you will tell me which sentence is correct. The store shut down last year, semicolon, their sales were too low. Or number 2, the store shut down last year, comma, their sales were too low. Which sentence is correct? You can see that both these sentences are complete sentences. They are independent clauses. And what is the rule? We should combine them through semicolon, right? So comma here is wrong. This is a run-on sentence. We cannot join 2 independent clauses through comma. We can join them either through semicolon or through coordinating conjunction. He was tired, semicolon, he didn't go to the party. Or he didn't go to the party, semicolon, because he was tired. Which one is correct, first or second? Yes, you are right. First one is correct, because here both the sentences are complete sentences. They are independent clauses. But in the second option, one sentence is complete sentence and second sentence is dependent clause. It's an incomplete sentence, and we cannot join an incomplete sentence through semicolon. This is wrong. Okay, let's see one more example. Which sentence is correct here? You need to bring the following to the seminar, colon, your printed ticket and some identification, full stop. Or you need to bring the following to the seminar, semicolon, your printed ticket and some identification. If we are supposed to give the list, are we going to use colon or semicolon? You are right. We are going to use colon. Here semicolon would be wrong. Whenever we want to introduce a list, we will use colon. Next example, we have participants from London, England, Tokyo, Japan and Bombay, India. So here you can see a lot of commas. And second, we have participants from London, comma, England, semicolon, Tokyo, comma, Japan, semicolon and Bombay, comma, India. So which sentence is correct? Yes, you are right. The second one is correct. But because here all the list is quite clear just because of the semicolon, right? So all the items in the list are separated through semicolon and we don't have any confusion. For queries, comment below. Thank you so much for listening. See you in the next lecture with some other good topic. Until then, bye.